Hello children, Sairam, welcome to our English grammar class. So ready with your book and pen? Okay, fine. Now, last time when we met, we did sentences, right? And we just did some revision of what we have learned, right? What is sentence, right? So what is sentence? It's a group of words that make a complete sense, right? And we also learned about parts of a sentence. Which are they? Subject and predicate, right? These are two parts of a sentence. Subject and predicate. Now today we are going to just learn, not actually learn, we have already done it. So we are just going to recollect what we mean by kinds of sentences. Okay, so do you remember the different kinds of sentences? Can you tell me the different kinds of sentences? Yes, so I hope they are this. The first one is assertive sentence, interrogative sentence, imperative sentence, and the exclamatory sentence. Okay, so these are the four types. Which are they? Assertive sentence. And now assertive sentence can be both, right? It can be negative also and positive also. But it comes in a assertive sentence. And then it comes the interrogative sentence. Then the imperative sentence and the exclamatory sentence. Now, what is the work of assertive sentence? How to find out? Assertive sentence, what they do? They ask questions. Do they? No. So, they give some information, right? So, they give us some information. So, when the sentence is there, we have to see whether that sentence is giving some information to us, isn't it? So, assertive sentence, they give some information. Then comes the interrogative sentence. So, here, this sentence, okay, how to find out whether the sentence is interrogative? They ask question, okay? The sentence asks question and in the end, what we get? Question mark, not a full stop, right? In assertive, we have full stop. But in interrogative, the end of a sentence, we put a question mark. Then comes imperative sentence. Now, how to find out the imperative sentence? It expresses a request. Okay, you can find in a sentence a request or an advice, right? Or any order is given, a command is given. Such type of sentence are called as imperative sentence. Then comes the exclamatory sentence. Yes, again what they do? They express a strong feeling, right? Of anger, happiness, surprise, sorrow, or even fear, isn't it? So these are the four kinds of sentences. Okay, now let's start with the examples, exercises which are given in your book. Okay, so the first question is, classify the following sentences into assertive, interrogative, imperative or exclamatory. So we have to just find out. Okay. So here the sentence goes, let us go for a river bath. Now this sentence, what it is doing? It's giving some information. Yes? No? Then is it asking question? Then is there any request or a feeling? Yes, it is. What? It is a request, isn't it? So, it is imperative sentence. Okay? So, you have to find out which type of sentence it is. So, the first one, it is an imperative sentence. May he be happy and prosperous. Now, again, which type here? What you are doing here? May he be happy and prosperous. Again, it is an imperative, isn't it? may he be happy and prosperous. So again, it is imperative sentence. It is expressing something, right? A request, advice, wishes, isn't it? Next one. Stop the traffic. Stop the traffic. Now, which type it is? Imperative, isn't it? It is also imperative sentence. Okay, it is giving you an order, a command. Stop the traffic. So, it is an imperative sentence. Fourth one. Is he a person to be trusted? Now, here at the end of the sentence, we can find what? Question mark, right? So, it is simple to understand, isn't it? So, which type it is? Interrogative sentence. A question is asked here, isn't it? Is he? Right? Is he a person to be trusted? So, answer is interrogative sentence. There is no stop nearby. There is no stop nearby. Again, what here it is doing? It is giving some information, isn't it? It is giving information. So, it is what? It is an assertive sentence. Isn't it? What it is? It is an assertive sentence. It is giving us some information. Where are the children? Again, simple. It is started with the question words. Where? And ending with question mark. So, it is an interrogative sentence. Isn't it? So, where are the children? It is an interrogative sentence. The train is not running on time. The train is not running on time. Again, what it is? The sentence tells us. It is giving us some information, isn't it? So, what it is? Assertive sentence. Okay? So, it is an assertive sentence. Next one. Ah, what a lovely rose. Our feelings, right? Is expressing some feelings here. So, what it is? Exclamatory sentence. Okay? What a lovely rose. Here we can see the exclamation marks, isn't it? So, they are the exclamatory sentence. Call in the doctor, please. Call in the doctor, please. Now, the word please itself tells us that it is a request made by someone, right? So, request means what type of sentence? Imperative sentence, right? It is a imperative sentence. Please pass the sugar. Please pass the sugar. Again, a request is done. So, what it is? Imperative sentence. It is a imperative sentence. Night is very beautiful. So, again here, giving some information, right? Night is very beautiful. So, it is assertive sentence. It is assertive sentence. India and Pakistan are neighboring countries. India and Pakistan are neighboring countries. So, what this sentence is doing here? It is giving us some information again. So, it is an assertive sentence. What it is? Assertive sentence. Now, another exercise we'll be doing, okay? Make sentences as directed using the word mother. So, the word is given, which it is? Mother, right? So, the word is given and what we have to do with it now? Okay, so what we'll do? We have to make a sentence using the word mother. And that sentence should be assertive, okay? Or it is also called as declarative, isn't it? So, we have to form a sentence with the word, using the word, okay? We have to frame a sentence using the word mother, but that sentence should be assertive sentence, okay? Now, here you can make your own sentence, okay? Otherwise, you can just see what I have written. So, here I have written, my mother is very beautiful. My mother is very beautiful. Okay, assertive. I'm giving what here? Assertive means what? Giving some information that my mother is very beautiful. Now, interrogative sentence. Now, we have to make interrogative sentence. Okay, we have to frame the interrogative sentence by using the word mother. So, here it goes. What is your mother's name? Okay. What is your mother's name? We have put a question mark there, isn't it? And we have started with the question word also. What? What is your mother's name? Now, the exclamatory sentence we have to frame by using the word mother. Let's see. Wow, my mother is looking beautiful. Okay, so here is the exclamatory sentence. Wow, we have put the exclamation mark. My mother is looking beautiful. Now, imperative sentence, right? So, imperative sentence we have to form here. Okay, means a request, isn't it? So, it will be, please, mother, let me go out to play. Please, mother, let me go out to play. Now, the word please itself tells that it's a request, right? You cannot order or command your mother, isn't it? That's a bad manner, isn't it? Yeah. So, we have to request. Here, we have to use your request. So, what we did here? Please. We added the word please, which became a request word. So, please, mother, let me go out to play. So, let's move ahead. Now, read the sentences given below. Complete the crossword puzzle with the subject or a verb in the predicate as directed. Okay, so here is a puzzle in your book. You can see in your book, right? Before that, you have few words written there. What we have to do? We have to complete the puzzle. Now, with the help of the subject or a verb in the predicate. As directed. So, they have told us here. They have given some information here. Let's see what is that. Now, here, we across. Okay, it is given across. Across means how you will go. Across, when you have the puzzle, it is the slipping line. Okay, it is the slipping line. So, here, it is given. We left the party early. Now, what we have to find here in this subject? Isn't it? What we have to find out? We have to find out the subject here. So, here you can see what is the subject now. Can you see the subject? We left the party early. So, what is the subject? We are talking about whom? Now, you know what is subject, isn't it? Yeah, so we is the subject, right? Isn't it? Are you sure? We is the subject here? Yes. Next. The doctor gave me some medicine. Now, here. Verb in the predicate. Which is the verb here? Gave. Okay. Gave. Then comes the third one. Mrs. Neeta bought tickets for the show. Now here you have to find out what? Verb in the predicate. Now which is the verb here? Bought. Isn't it? Next one. Molly moved to Delhi. Now which is the subject? About whom we are talking? We are talking about Molly, right? So, Molly is the subject here. Then, the bird flew over my head. Now, verb in the predicate. Now, which is the verb here? Flew. Then, the children are in school today. Which is the subject here? Children, right? We are talking about children. So, here we got our crosswords. Okay, the highlighted words are actually the answers which we have to fit into the puzzle. Okay, so for one, we have to put we. For number two, gave. Three, bought. Five, Molly. Six, flew. And the seventh one is children. Okay, so these are the answers for across words. Okay, that you know what is across now, right? This way. Okay, now let's move ahead. Now, here you have down. Down means what you will get now? Downwards, this way. You had to fill the puzzle. First one it is, father went to a dentist. Now, which is the verb in the predicate? Okay, you know what is predicate now. Okay, so which is the verb now here? Went, right? Okay, then the fourth one, Halloween is an American festival. which is the subject here? Yes, Halloween, right? Halloween is the subject. So we got our answers for number 1 down and number 4 down. Okay, now let's fill up this answer. Now here you can see, you in your book, you can find this puzzle, right? Numbers are written. Can you see there? 1. Can you see the number 1 there? Yes. You can very much see there, right? This is the number 1 there. Can you see? Right? You can see the number 1. We can see here very much. Then we have the number 2. Then the number 3. Number 4, 5, 6 and 7. Can you see? Okay, now the words which we have underlined, we have to fill it into this puzzles. Okay, now actually you should fill it. Fine? Will you do it? Okay, now what we did, we have underlined the words. Only work you have to do is, you have to fill them in the boxes which are given there. Will you do it? Are you ready? So just do it. Come on, start doing it. Yeah, I did it. So here you can see them. I filled them. Can you see? Yes, I filled. Our first was what letter? What was our first answer? V, right? So here it is. You can see V. I have written. Then our second was gave. So gave, you got it. Then we had the third one, bought, right? Then the fourth one was down, right? Fourth one was down. So it is Halloween. Fifth one was Molly. Sixth one was flew, right? And the seventh one was, yes, children. Now we also had one more, one standing, right? One down. So what it was? Went. Right? So in this way, we have our answers. Can you see them? Okay. So that is the puzzle which you have done. I hope you have done and not done the cheating here by just copying what answer I have given. Okay. So here we will stop for the day now. We have completed our exercise.